The data science life cycle made a lot of sense, and now I know that I want to define my problem before I do anything else. So my app is a service-based app. This means that it depends on not only usage data, but also external factors like weather and date. For example, how people rent bikes might look very different on a holiday compared to a workday. I know that I want to use the anonymized data that I collect in my app, as well as the external factors like date and weather, to make better informed decisions about how and where I place my bikes around the city. And I know that this initial analysis that we do today is just the first step. I'm going to take what I learn and I'm going to improve what data I collect and what questions I ask so I can be more successful in my app. So what does success look like to me? Well, for me, it means more people renting bikes. Now, I could spend a lot more money on marketing, but another way to do that is to make sure that my inventory, my bikes, are in the right place at the right time. Now, that's a pretty complex matrix, so let's dial it down a little bit more and focus on how many bikes I might need in a certain area in the next hour or day or a few minutes even. So that's going to be my question. I want to predict how many bikes will be rented in the next hour in a certain place. Then maybe I can move my inventory to that area and more bikes will be rented. So it looks like I've got a pretty good grasp of my business understanding. I don't really want to mess with my data quite yet. I want to get an initial analysis and understanding of what's going on first. So the next step is going to be modeling. Then I do want to try to deploy this as a web service because I want to try it out in the wild and see if I can make any predictions and improve this over time. So let's check back in with Francesca so that we can learn a little bit more about machine learning models and maybe find out which one we should use for our problem.